Hello, great people from all around the world. Today we're going to talk about a whole bunch of stuff. Stuff ranging from technology to sports don't go well together. Well, they used to not. Now there are nerds who play sports and sports players who play World of Warcraft. Well, maybe not the second one, but you know what I'm saying. Anyway, today we're going to talk about multiple things. You see, this is the show called After Hours. It's not just any show. You are with me, Victor Espinosa, and we are going to discuss the most serious topics in the world. My first guest is Ronnie Otto James Circelli.
The third.
The third. Like I am Victor Hugo Espinosa the third.
Ronnie!
So, Ronnie, what do you think about YouTube?
It's like, I remember when it first came out and I was like, you can basically search anything you ever could like imagine. And I was like, this is like the most amazing thing ever, because they had like music videos to like videos that people just made. And it's just like, it was like hours of fun.
Then what happened, Ronnie?
It got kind of boring.
Well, apparently you haven't seen any of Ray William Johnson's videos.
No.
Well, he's the best YouTube person ever.
Why?
Because he's awesome.
Okay, what makes him awesome?
He has funny stuff, I don't know. And he made the song, Doing Your Mother. Yes, that's a real song.
What? Really? I don't think he's the best.
He's pretty cool. But besides that, I'd also want to talk to you about MySpace and Facebook. What do you think about MySpace and Facebook?
Social networks are cool. I mean, they're a great way for people to, you know, talk on the internet and stuff. It's like, it's become big in the world today. And it's mostly Facebook now. I mean, people like aren't on MySpace as much anymore.
Do you think Facebook ripped off MySpace?
Not really. I mean, if you come up with an idea that's similar to someone else's, but you make it better, that's their fault, MySpace, for not being as good as possible. But it's going to happen. I mean, in America, when something different else comes out, everyone forgets about the old. And
like the iPhone?
No. Yeah.
I was disgusted, and I hate Apple, I got to tell you that.
Why?
Because it's just so lame.
They're good.
It's too expensive, and it's so trendy. You know what I mean?
No.
It's too trendy.
No.
It's trendy. They made up the word. I'm pretty sure they change the word application to app. Like, people use the word app, like the killer app, but they never said it like they do now. Like, now they say, apps for your phone. I'm like, dude, shut the hell up. It's called an application.
I have an iTouch, and I'm very happy with it.
Well, it's expensive, Ronnie. And you say that someone doesn't do anything for you. I'm not going to name any names here. And they get you an iPhone.
Well, it wasn't all them.
Sure, whatever, Ronnie. Keep telling yourself that. Keep telling yourself that you do things, Ronnie. Keep telling yourself. Anyway, while you are executive producer of this show, I am the main producer and the host. How does that make you feel, Ronnie?
Great. Really good. I've got a feeling this is going to do really good, this show.
All right, that's good. That's good, because I'm your boss, Ronnie. I'm your boss.
Okay, sure.
Anyway, so a lot of movies come out. What do you think is the most overrated movie of all time?
Avatar was pretty overrated when it came out.
Yeah, I think Avatar, I knew you were going to answer like that, because I know everyone thinks Avatar is
everyone
overrated.
Everyone was like, oh my God, it's the greatest movie in the world. And
it's a horrible story. It's a racist story, honestly. It's an anti-white story. And it's also an anti-Native American story and an anti-black story.
All those things combined.
Yeah, but they're stereotypes. They're stereotypes of people, of indigenous peoples from other countries. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And this country, of course. Yeah, it's a metaphor. It's saying people who aren't white are savages and white people are assholes. I'm going to bleep that out.
But I didn't think the graphics and stuff was all that good.
The graphics were pretty good. I think they
were okay, but I
think District 9 was much better.
I didn't really like the story.
You didn't like the story of District 9? It was amazing.
I'm not into these, like, sci-fi aliens.
Shut up,
movies.
Ronnie. Yeah. Shut up. Yeah. You don't know anything.
You shut up, Victor.
You know what? You know what is the most overrated movie of all time?
What?
Star Wars. Think about it. Just actually think about it. It's a good movie.
I don't know.
But think about the first Star Wars movie. Or the fourth, but what, it's the first.
I don't think they're that overrated.
I think they're very overrated. Think about it. What is so great about Star Wars?
It was a good movie, and it has the respect it deserves.
If that movie came out now, do you think people would say it's a great movie?
Yeah.
The effects are horrible.
Well, the story is ridiculous. The newer ones are good.
No, they're the ones that make me want to vomit. I mean, they're okay.
Yeah, exactly.
But that's it. They're okay. They're good. Let's say they're good. They're good movies. They're like maybe even 4.5 stars. They're really good movies, but they're just not that great.
And they're bringing in a lot of money.
They're just not that. I know that's the reason.
When people understand that there's going to be another Star Wars, they're going to go see it.
I know, yeah, but what is so great about the story of the movie? It's kind of cheesy.
Exactly. There's not anything else like
it. It's so cliche, though, at the same time. Like, I like the movies, and I love watching them, but do they really deserve all the titles that they have now?
Exactly.
They are considered the greatest movies of all time by many.
I don't know.
Exactly. That. You know what I think is a great movie?
What?
Space Odyssey.
I just saw Resident Evil Afterlife in 3D. Amazing
that movie. But
that was an amazing movie.
But let me tell you, see, movies like that, they're action movies. They're great and all. Yeah. It was based off, it's the only video game movies besides the first Mortal Kombat movie that actually did well.
Yeah.
Video game movies always do bad. And movie video games always do bad.
Yeah.
But sometimes things just get weird. Have you ever heard of the E.T. original video game?
The E.T. video game?
It was the worst video game of all time. In editing, I'm going to show you a clip of this.
Here's what the star of Universal's hit movie looks like after making the change from the silver screen to the video screen. Atari has made E.T. a star for the second time in the most eagerly awaited video game cartridge since Pac-Man. As in the movie, E.T. is brought to Earth by his spaceship and gets stranded in the woods. The object, as if you didn't know, is to get E.T. home. You must locate three pieces of his intergalactic telephone, call his spaceship, and get him to the landing site in time. Otherwise, the spaceship leaves without him. Search through the woods scene first until you find the landing site. There it is. And continue looking for the phone home zone. When you find it, press the action button, and a call automatically goes out to the spaceship. A timer appears at the top of the screen. You must be at the landing site when the timer runs down, or E.T. will miss his ride home. That's why we recommend finding the landing site first. We can arrive with plenty of time to spare, and just wait for the timer to run out. After the spaceship picks up E.T., watch as Elliot adds bonus points for the candy pieces we've given him throughout the game.
And now, it's a horrible movie. I'll just tell you that right now. Yeah. It's just pathetic.
Like the movie or the game?
The game. But it's a movie in a way. It's so epically horrible that it deserves a movie.
Games are movies in a way if you think about it.
They're like a controllable movie.
But it's like interactive
movie.
See,
you win these things when you do good in a movie.
Oh, yeah.
But you don't win that when you do a good game based off a movie. You know why?
Why?
Because there's never been a good game based off of a movie. Name one good game that's based off a movie. It's just sad. I mean,
I can't name any. You're right.
Goodbye. Just this is an emotional moment for me.
Atari, juegos para el televisor. Atari entretiene, educa y une a la familia con más variedad de juegos. exija la garantía de servicio de Grafex S.A.
What about Lady Gaga being a man? Do you believe that Lady Gaga
no,
is a man?
No, I love Lady Gaga. She's not a man.
And isn't she working on a new album?
Yeah, she is. I'm looking forward to it.
Now, I don't want to say this in public, because if Lady Gaga is a man, that would be a really bad thing for me to say. But I just don't believe Lady Gaga can be a man. She's too attractive to be a man, let's just say.
I wouldn't say attractive.
I know a lot of people look ew. But honestly, I mean, people are so, like, some guys, they're just like, oh, I don't like that girl. But they, like, they say things, like, they act like they're very selective, but let's get something straight. We all know that most people would definitely, I don't want to say the word, so I'm just going to say something Lady Gaga if they had a chance. But if she has a penis, that's going to be, never mind.
How dare you?
And this guy is just like Lady Gaga. We
really?
Don't know if he's a guy or a girl.
It's a guy.
How can you tell it's a guy?
It's a guy.
I'm pretty sure it's not a guy. Especially if he's standing on a podium holding it like this. I mean, guys don't... Have you seen... I barely ever see guys hold their books like this.
No, he's pounding his chest like he's King Kong.
No, he's not. King Kong does not pound his chest like this. I can't even see him from here, so I'm going to go... He is definitely not pounding his chest. He's holding this thing. Oh, crap. Whatever it is. See, and I'm educated. I know what it is. I just can't say it.
Wait, what?
I don't know. I don't know what it is. I'm just trying to be... All right, anyway. He's holding it like... this, like how a girl holds her book sometimes, like that.
I've never seen a girl hold her books like that.
I've seen girls hold their books like on their chest like this when they're littler, like when we were in middle school. We are in high school because I'm young. And anyway, I'm pretty sure this guy is pretty androgynous.
Define androgynous.
You can't tell if he's a guy or a girl. I mean, he has male characteristics. But in some ways, he's kind of like a girl. And some people are really androgynous, like Justin Bieber himself. I cannot tell. When I first heard his voice, I couldn't tell if it was a guy or a girl. I thought it was like a homely girl.
I thought it was
girl.
A girl.
And when I saw his face, he looked kind of like a girl. And I was like, that girl looks like a lesbian. And don't be offended by that. Any lesbians.
I agree.
Because the hair and the dressing like a guy thing, I don't know. I thought it was a girl dressed as a guy. All I know is he's 15. Did you know that?
I thought he was older.
You thought he was older? Oh, maybe he's 16.
Yeah, he's 16.
He's 16.
He just got a car from like Usher or something.
He can drive?
Yeah, that's
scary. He looks like he's 12.
I know. Range Rover. Really? He drives a Range Rover.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure someone else drives him around. All I know is
probably
he gets a lot of chicks, but he hasn't gone through puberty yet, so he will break in half, like the break we're going to go to right now. Glad for having you on the show, Madeline.
It's nice being here.
What do you say, BK?
You gonna tell me the concept for this telephone video or what?
Well,